New Discoveries at Jamestown by John L. Cotter and J. Paul Hudson. Artisans and Craftsmen. Numerous objects recovered at Jamestown are extremely important as they reveal the kinds of craftsmen and artisans who worked in Virginia's first capital, the nature of their tools and equipment, and examples of their handiwork. The Carpenter. Scores of tools used by the men who helped build the Jamestown houses have been unearthed, including chisels, augers, gouges, hammers, reamers, saw fragments, bits, axes and hatchets, plane blades, gimlets, files, calipers, compasses, scribers, nail pulls, and a saw rest. A grindstone was found in a refuse pit not far from the historic church tower. The Cooper. Some tools used by the cooper, including draw shaves, adzes, plane irons, and race knives, have been excavated. Several barrel staves, probably made at Jamestown, were found in a few wells. Because of the great demand for barrels, casks, and hogsheads, both in Virginia and England, the Jamestown cooper was a busy artisan. His products were needed at all times, especially after 1620, when the Virginia settlers began shipping large quantities of tobacco to England in wooden hogsheads. Illustration caption: Timbering, one of the first English industries in the New World. Painting by Sidney E. King. End of caption. Illustration caption: An early 17th century two-man crosscut saw. End of caption. The woodcutter and sawyer. Numerous tools found on Jamestown Island relate to timbering, including felling axes, hewing axes, hatchets, saws, and wedges. An early 17th century two-man crosscut saw has been recovered almost intact. Records indicate that pit saws were used, although none has been excavated. The iron worker. A small primitive hearth or furnace, where small amounts of iron may have been smelted during the early part of the 17th century, was uncovered during archaeological explorations in 1955. A few miles upriver from Jamestown, at Falling Creek, the English built their first iron furnace in America in 1620-21. Iron was smelted in the furnace, and a few tools were forged, the first iron objects made in the New World by the English. In 1622, the Indians massacred the iron workers and their families, and destroyed the furnace. Although it was never rebuilt, its importance cannot be overstressed, for the Falling Creek site can rightfully claim the honor of being the birthplace of the American iron industry. Illustration caption: A few of many tools unearthed at Jamestown which were used for timbering: felling axes, a hewing axe, adz, hatchet, wedge, and saw fragment. End of caption. Illustration caption: Making trials of iron. Evidences of an earth oven or small furnace were discovered at Jamestown during archaeological explorations. Small amounts of iron may have been smelted in the furnace during the early years of the settlement. Conjectural sketch by Sidney E. King. End of caption. The blacksmith. In 1955, archaeologists discovered the remnants of an early 17th century forge. At the site, blacksmith's tools, bar iron, sword guards, unfinished iron objects, and slag were found. This gave evidence that a blacksmith once plied his trade only a few yards west of the ancient brick church. Many blacksmiths worked at Jamestown. There was one among the first group of settlers. In the Jamestown collection are many tools which they left behind, including pliers, pincers, chisels, punches, hammers, and a small anvil. The boat builder. Many small boats were built at Jamestown. They were built by English shipwrights and carpenters, who came from a long line of efficient craftsmen. These small vessels afforded the principal means of transportation through the uncharted wilderness tidewaters of Virginia. They were used for fishing, trade, and discovery. A few small hand-wrought iron tools used by Jamestown boat builders have been excavated on the historic island. The Potter. In 1955, a pottery kiln site was discovered at Jamestown. Nearby was found many utilitarian earthenware vessels of the 1625 to 1640 period. Definite evidence that pottery was made in Virginia over 300 years ago. Although made for everyday use, many of the pieces unearthed are symmetrical and not entirely lacking in beauty. The unknown Jamestown potters were artisans, trained in the mysteries of an ancient craft, who first transplanted their skills to the Virginia wilderness. Illustration caption: objects found at a 17th century forge site at Jamestown, blacksmith's tools, bar iron, a few incomplete items, sword guards, and slag. It appears that the forge was in operation as early as 1625. End of caption. Illustration caption: building a small boat at Jamestown about 1650. Painting by Sidney E. King. End of caption. Illustration caption: boat building tools found, all made before 1700. End of caption. Illustration caption: earthenware vessels made at Jamestown between 1625 and 1640. The site of an early 17th century pottery kiln was discovered on the island in 1955. End of caption. Illustration caption: making pottery at Jamestown about 1625 to 1640. Painting by Sidney E. King. End of caption. Illustration caption: artifacts found near the site of the Jamestown glass house, which was in operation as early as 1608. A small melting pot, part of a working hole, fragment from large melting pot, cullet, broken or refuse glass, shown in lower left corner, and green glass fragments, lower center and lower right. End of caption. Illustration caption: blowing glass at Jamestown in 1608. Conjectural sketch by Sidney E. King. End of caption. The glass blower. Glass blowers were working at Jamestown in 1608 to 09, and again in 1621 to 24. The trial glass they made in 1608 was sent to England, the first glass manufactured by Englishmen in the New World. The small glass fragments excavated at the furnace sites do not reveal what was produced, but probably nothing more complicated than window glass, bottles and vials, and plain drinking glasses. It is believed that the small glass factory at Jamestown was the first English factory in America. The brickmaker and tile maker. Four brick kilns have been excavated. In two of them, roofing tile and bricks were found. An iron spade, probably used in preparing the clay for brickmaking, was found in one of the kilns. The oldest kiln unearthed is believed to have been in use as early as 1625. Many brickmakers emigrated to Jamestown during the 1600s. The lime burner. Four lime kilns were unearthed on the historic island, where oyster shells from the James River were burned and converted into lime by the lime burner. As early as 1610, lime burners emigrated to Virginia, and thereafter many such workers came to the colony from England. Illustration caption: four brick kilns have been excavated. The one shown had five firing chambers. Roofing tiles were also made in the Jamestown brick kilns. End of caption. Illustration caption: a 17th century lime kiln excavated at Jamestown. In it, oyster shells from the James River were burned for making lime. The iron hoops, which supported the arched top of the kiln, buckled from the intense heat. End of caption. Illustration caption: making lime from oyster shells in a kiln, about 1625. Conjectural sketch by Sidney E. King. End of caption. Other craftsmen. Contemporary records, confirmed by certain objects found at Jamestown, especially small tools, revealed that pewterers, silversmiths, colliers, wheelwrights, caulkers, bricklayers, millwrights, shoemakers, masons, cordage makers, tanners, tobacco pipe makers, armorers, gun makers, braziers, and others worked in the capital city at various periods between 1607 and 1699. Illustration caption: a silversmith weighing clipped coins. Conjectural sketch by Sidney E. King. End of caption. Illustration caption. Brass weights and a piece of scrap brass unearthed at Jamestown. Records indicate that many metal workers emigrated to Virginia during the 17th century. End of caption. Home industries. During archaeological explorations, many artifacts relating to household and town industries were recovered. It is believed that many of these small industries were home activities carried on in the houses at Jamestown. A few of these activities and the products of them are mentioned briefly. Spinning and weaving. A few metal parts from spinning wheels and looms have been excavated, reminders that the pioneer housewife who spun the thread and yarn and wove the cloth for her large family was seldom idle. Malting and brewing. One Jamestown building or house, whose brick foundations were discovered in 1955, appears to have been used for malting and brewing beer and ale, or carrying out some activity requiring distillation. A few pieces of lead were found which may have been part of a lead cistern for holding barley. The three brick ovens that were uncovered may have been used as drying kilns. A handle from a copper kettle was found near one of the ovens, and pieces of copper and lead pipes were unearthed not far from the building. The structure itself appears to have been used between 1625 and 1660. Illustration caption. Spinning thread or yarn and weaving cloth were endless chores for the women living in the small wilderness settlement. Conjectural sketch by Sidney E. King. End of caption. Illustration caption. Brewing beer at Jamestown. Conjectural sketch by Sidney E. King. End of caption. Dairying and cheesemaking. Earthenware milk pans, bowls and pots, iron hoops from wooden vessels, an earthenware funnel, and parts of skimmers, sieves, and ladles have been excavated. All these are evidence that dairying was an important household industry. This activity was usually carried on in a brick-paved room with slatted windows located on the northwest side of the house. Cheese, as well as butter, was probably made in the same room. Illustration caption. Lead and copper pipes, kettle fragments, a brass spigot, and other items found which may have been used for brewing or distilling purposes. End of caption. Baking. One of the largest objects that has been found is an earthenware baking oven, which was unearthed in an old ditch near the site of the May Hartwell house. Restored from over 200 fragments, the oven was probably used between 1650 and 1690. It may have been made at Jamestown, molded of native clay and fired in a pottery kiln. In use, heated stones were placed inside the oven and left until the walls were hot enough for baking. Sometimes, however, the oven may have been placed directly on the embers of the fire. It undoubtedly was used out of doors, near a small house. Associated industries. A few artifacts that have been recovered are associated with millers, drapers, basket makers, cutlers, tailors, barbers, net makers, and glovers. These tradesmen usually worked in or near their homes. Illustration caption. Earthenware milk pan, brass ladle, funnel fragment, and other items found which relate to dairying and cheesemaking. End of caption. Illustration caption. Baking bread in an outdoor baking oven, about 1650. Conjectural sketch by Sidney E. King. End of caption. Illustration caption. In this oven, a Jamestown woman baked bread over 300 years ago. It appears to have been in use between 1650 and 1690. End of caption. Illustration caption. Jamestown soldiers carrying pole arms, a halberd and a bill. Conjectural sketch by Sidney E. King. End of caption. End of section.